Buddy, get a little less than Jake in there, a little, that's the equivalent of, like, the adrenaline needle in Pulp Fiction. Like, I'm kind of, like, you know, it's hot in here, struggling, kind of got a little bit of a head cold or allergies type thing. Little less than Jake, needle right to the heart. Wide open for a stream today. Good morning, good afternoon, everybody, wherever you at. Hey, Tim Ferrari, good to see you. Alicia Jerry, Paul Grazulius. Went from just finding us to squad member to catching World of Haiku streams. I love it, Paul. Good to see you on the West Coast there. Hey, Ben, how you doing? Good to see you. LinkedIn, folks, we got a great show for you today. It's Monday, which means only one thing. We're diving in to the World of Haiku. Every other week on the channel, we play either Haiku Pro or World of Haiku. Spoiler, get ready, too, because these two platforms are going to be merged at some point, and we're just going to have Haiku unified, which is pretty exciting. But today is a World of Haiku. Now you might be asking, what is World of Haiku, Jerry? World of Haiku is a platform that is designed for anybody of any background, any experience, to be able to learn basic Linux command line shell type stuff, right? Like file management, secure shell, connecting, some networking stuff like curl and ping and IP config or IF config, right? And also some basic cybersecurity tools like John the Ripper, Nmap, which is a seminal tool. Everybody knows how to use Nmap. And Hydra, for example, also Durbuster, SQL Map, other things like that. So it really is a beautiful self-contained platform that can really educate you on the intricacies of the beginning of a cybersecurity career. And I'll tell you what, I have never seen a platform, and you know, this is my Jerry Osier's opinion on this, right? This isn't a Haiku opinion. I've never seen a better approach to getting someone comfortable on a Linux command line. You know, like, you know, I remember when I was in college, like really young, like setting up a Linux machine and like just, you know, didn't even have a GUI and just like straight up terminal shell. I'm like, what am I doing here? What do I do? And, you know, looking back now, it's just second nature to, you know, be like LS and see where you are and change directories and whatever. But if you don't know, you don't know. So it really is a powerful platform. Hey, Alicia Jerry, you're going to be passive observer today. That's great. And then there's Haiku Pro, which stay tuned. Next week, we'll be doing Haiku Pro live on the channel as well. What are we doing? I see some applause in here. Just kind of scrolling through chat really quickly. This game also makes my cheap Logitech keyboard mouse combo sound like a thocky cyberpunk mechanical keyboard. I love it, Chris Hidalgo. I do love it. There has been some quality of life updates on the World of Haiku platform, which we're going to showcase today. So if you're here, let me tell Twitter that we're here. One button tweet out that we're going to be streaming right now. If you got any questions, my energy level's at like 80%, y'all. So I'm looking to have a really chill stream. I want to do some Hydra brute forcing for brute forcing access onto accounts. We'll do that in what they call the dojos. I'll show you around the World of Haiku, but feel free to holler at me in chat. I do want to have a really kind of chill and engaging stream today. So if you got any questions, let me know. and we'll get into it. So let's jump over to Haiku. All right, here we are in World of Haiku. Hello, LinkedIn folks. Oh, Randock Gaming, my man. Where we at?
What? Did we just become best friends?
Yep.
I want to show it on stream. Randock Gaming with the super chat. Whoops, my graphics are mirrored. Super chat right there. Thank you so much, Randock Gaming. We got the hype up. Yes, we got the hype. I need my son to get me some water. See if he'll come in here and hook me up with some water. I can't go off stream. Paul says he agrees with the statement. He bought in Star World of Haiku weeks ago, been occupied with Google Search Journey. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, you know, I mean, one of the best things about World of Haiku is that they use this technique called learning engineering that's quite popular. Hey, did you see my note? Will you fill this up with water, please? I'm live right now. I can't really. Thanks. You don't have to fill it all the way up, just like 3/4 of the way. Thanks, son. Hey, what's up, Jesbo? Good day, Jerry. I got to get to work in a couple hours, but I'd love to stick around and join in. Yes. Cool, man. Jesbo's hang out. Yeah, thanks, James Randolph. I really think it's allergies and stuff. The good news is I think my 80% energy is like a lot of people's 100% because I'm just wide open all the time. But we're going to get through it. It's going to be fun. We'll have a good time today together. Trust me. All right. So here's World of Haiku. You can see the new look and feel. I like it. I like what they've done here. The menu's on the right over here. We got the Rascal. I'm going to go ahead and just show you a little bit. We've got the achievements for streaks, skill tree of things you can learn. It keeps track of it. So it World of Haiku is a video game at its heart, but you've got to remember it is actually doing something. It's the same thing as saying like Duolingo is a video game. World of Haiku teaches you fundamental Linux and cybersecurity skills, and it keeps track of it and it reports to you. It keeps track of your accomplishments. It's very, very, very cool. It's to just call it a video game would be an understatement of what it's actually doing. Oh my God, double pink eye, Ben. That's horrible. Thanks so much. I appreciate that. My oldest son, Ben, said he feels bad for you. He just got over it though, Grace, so he's doing good. Thanks so much. All right, so I'm only normal human today here. Hey, is it wicked hot in here for you too? I'm wicked hot. All right, hold on. All right, so World of Haiku is doing all this. You can see it keeps track of there's notifications on things that you've doing. Ooh, you can do social shares and stuff like that. It's pretty cool. I'm just gonna jump into the game really quickly and show you what we're doing. There's links in the description below if you want to play this, if you want to check it out. You can see it's mapped up with 8 different worlds. Now, I'm playing the explore mode because I've already completed this game, but there's 8 worlds and each world has 2 missions, mission 1 and mission 2. And the whole thing is like this, you know, story with rich characters and good guys and bad guys. And, you know, you're kind of like Luke Skywalker, for lack of a better term, starting off with like not really knowing anything, corresponding to your own experience within cybersecurity. And then throughout the 8 worlds, you begin to uncover and learn skills and stuff like that. It's very, very cool. So if you look closely, though, you can see these 3 green Tories. I know it's kind of hard to see on stream, but these are dojos and they correspond to different tools within the platform. So this is the Nmap dojo, this is the John the Ripper dojo, and this is the Hydra dojo. Now I'm just gonna jump in one world really quickly just to kind of show you briefly what the game looks like, because the dojos look a little different. But in this, you can see I've gone into world 2A and it tells us what we're going to do. The mission is dealer's choice, so there's like a video game piece to it, but we're going to use curl, discover web servers, we're going to use the ping tool. I see people talking about yerba mate. Is that like what's that yeasty stuff that Australians eat? There's like a yeast drink or something you guys drink. I don't know if any of you are Australian, but there's like a yeast drink. Vegemite? Is that a drink or a food? I don't even know. I don't know. All right, so you can see right when I popped up. Here, let me move my camera. I know this is going to be really jarring for many of you, but Whoa! So when it pops up, you can see here on the right of the screen, there is a terminal shell, right? So you can see like echo, hi, I'm the terminal shell. Okay. This is the terminal shell. This is like what every Linux machine's gonna have. You're gonna be able to interact with it and basically interface with the operating system. Oh, thank you, Gary. Vegemite is food. Okay, now you can see here, again, this is supposed to be like a one-player mission thing. So Rascal is kind of like our C-3PO, if you will, or our Obi-Wan Kenobi. I think more like C-3PO, though. Oh, okay, I see, Chris Cahill. So you can make a T of it. Yeah, you know, I know some people who are like, live and die by like, oh, tea is like the way to go. Like you can get English breakfast and get jazzed up, or you can have like chamomile in the evenings and jazz down. But I don't know. Maybe I'll try some tea. But for me, guys, many of you are obviously squad members and I recognize you and you're here in the morning streams every morning. But Starbucks French roast is my jam. I like it. It just hits every right way for me. Like even just talking about it, I'm like, oh, that's so good. So I think I've tried the tea. Occasionally I'll get into the tea if I'm coffeeed out, but for the most part, I'm all in on coffee, specifically Starbucks French roast coffee. And if I'm like really jonesing or whatever, or like I'm in a pinch, they have like these like little vapor, like Starbucks has like, they're called singles or something like that. It's like a powder and you add hot water. The Italian roast one's okay. Tim Ferrari, that coffee makes you sweat. Tim, I don't know if you were part of the Simply Cyber community a few months ago, but I did like this trial with three different coffees. I was going to have like some, like a company was going to make a Simply Cyber coffee and I was going to be able to, you know, sell it and it would be the coffee. And I agreed to let them send me the coffee and I was going to try all, I think there was five different coffees and one of them was like a decaf, so I threw that away. No one needs that. And then I tried the coffees and I didn't like any of them enough to like go with it. And I certainly wasn't going to continue to drink Starbucks and tell the community that I was drinking something else. That would have been fraudulent. But one of the coffees, Tim, one of the coffees was called Crank. And like, you want to talk about sweating. I was like out of my mind. It was the most outrageous stream. I actually told the Simply Cyber community that maybe for like April Fool's Day or like for like a special day of some sort, I would drink it on the morning briefing, but I was like lit up. It was appropriately named Crank. So guys, you can see that there's been some visual improvements. I don't know if you guys remember, but like the Messenger app used to take up a huge amount of space and now it's much more minimalized and it looks really good. I haven't seen it yet myself and this is great. I can't wait to tell the dev team about that. Plus you can see the network right here, the IP addresses. It says the website's accessible, so use curl, okay, curl tool. Let's see, ping is a tool. See, it's teaching you, right? If you didn't know what ping is, it explains. Ping's a tool we use to test if a device is active and if you can access it. Type ping, and then the IP address, 191.192.1.80. Now, what I want to point out here is two things. One, it's teaching me by telling me. Then it's teaching me by having me type it in so I'm getting practical hands-on keyboard experience. And I'm seeing it happen. You know, my 8-year-old actually came in earlier today. I had it up because I was getting ready for the stream. And he came in and he said, hey, what's that, Dad? And I said, oh, it's a video game that teaches you cybersecurity. And he's like, oh, cool. And I was like, you want to try it? He's like, not right now. But I honestly believe an 8-year-old, like, you know, it doesn't matter. Say you're like 48 years old and you're pivoting careers. You could still get value out of this. This isn't designed for children. But an 8-year-old could pick it up, which is what's really cool about it. All right, so you can see how the ping command is just continuing to go. On Linux, you have to manually stop it. You can see here it's telling you how to manually stop it by hitting Control-C. We send the interrupt request, and boom, it's done. Now, It does have the man pages if we want to learn more about ping later on, right? So we're always able to go access that just like a real computer, a real Linux instance, excuse me. CURL stands for client URL. Did not know that. I did not know that. See, even I learned something. And I got, you know, gray in my beard up in here. So we're going to CURL that IP address. Again, it tells us what it does, and then it asks us to type it in. This is using learning engineering methodologies. If you want to learn more about learning engineering, check out Carnegie Mellon's Human Interface Lab. All right, ready? So we're going to CURL, and I have to put the protocol in front of it. And we CURLed. All a CURL is the same thing as like what your Google Chrome web browser, your Firefox, or your Netscape Navigator, if you're wicked old school. It's the same thing, except when you CURL, it brings it back as text instead of having some rendering engine render it through HTML onto your web browser, right? So that's a good way to do it. CURL is a nice little quick trick to see if, like, you know, a website's up or pull something down. 6-year-old learning about economy and Roblox. I know, BitCirc, are you talking about the tycoon games or whatever? Hey Bjorn, good to see you in chat. Dr. Alien asks if I tried ThreatGen. Yeah, I have tried ThreatGen. I used to work with ThreatGen quite a bit, Dr. Alien. Good platform. I would say ThreatGen is good, just in a different way. Yeah. All right, so it says rascals highlighted kidlist.com. I bet that URL resolves to 191, 192, 180. So let's look for another link that points to CURL. All right. So we're going to CURL link. So you could see here we did CURL with an IP address, but now it's saying we can do CURL with a website, okay? Let me know if that music's too loud too. So we can CURL with the website, all right? Now, hopefully that made a lot of sense to you guys, right? Like, hold on one second. I wanna show you this really quickly. Here, let me do this really quickly. I'm just gonna do this. Give me a hot second. I don't think I'm gonna be able to show you guys this one way or the other. Hold on. I wanna show you something. Okay, hold on one second. Give me a second. Stand by. All right. All right, hold on. All right, check this out really quickly, okay? I can't see chat. All right, chat's gonna go up here for now. All right, so check this out. We just did CURL, right? Now you might be like, oh, that's kind of cool, right? Well, here, check it out. This right here, I know it's kind of be hard to see because my big face is in the way, but this is a Linux. This is a Kali Linux instance. This is my Kali box, okay? And I didn't really do this setup for this really well, but hold on, maybe I can do it this way. Hold on, you guys are getting to see how the sausage is made too. Here. Just bear with me for a minute. Okay, so you could see on stream here that this is my Kali box, right? So I could say CURL HTTP simplycyber.io, right? That didn't do anything. Hold on. Why is that not bringing anything back? Hold on one second. All right, so I did CURL Google, and you could see I just got the same stuff, right? So you can go from the video game into real life. And, you know, and just, you can do CURL and stuff, right? So the skills that you're picking up are directly applicable, like instantly applicable, you know what I'm saying? So that's like another thing about the game that's really cool. It's like using real commands in real life, not like, it's not like made up commands like a video game. All right, get out of here. I don't want to see my streaks right now. Yeah, Kali did come up with an update. You may be talking about Kali Purple, Chris K. Hall. Possibly Kali Purple, if not. I know my instance of Kali updated itself. So I don't stay really up on the release notes of Kali though. Oh, thanks, Stephen Browning. Okay, so we're able to curl this catalast.com website. Now, I'm clicking through the storyline. You know, my streams, I don't want to like get engrossed in the storyline of this game. I'm more interested in showing you guys how this platform can teach you Linux and cybersecurity, okay? Let's see if we can find an IP address. You can see here there's a services URL, so let's curl that, right? Again, you'll notice that now I'm using the curl command again. So this is part of learning engineering. It's reinforcing, reiterating that hands-on keyboard application. If you start using curl, you'll probably like learn about get and post, of course. There are many other options. That's right. That is so true. That is so true. And you can start putting, I might be mistaken, James, but you can do cookies and stuff too. Okay, so I just wanted to show you guys like how the interface looked on normal missions. Okay, so now let's go check out these Tories, okay? So I'm gonna do the Hydra one. Oh boy. This is called World of Haiku, Alexandra Primakova. You can check in the show notes or the description below. You'll see links to it all. All right. So this guy's a different like bot, but he's my, you can see he looks like a peep. He looks like a peep with a big hand, but they made him small. Here we go. So it's just laying out. how we do these things. So inside of the dojo, you can see it's kind of hard to see because there's a lot of like overlay stuff, but right up here are three flags, right? Find flagged file on Jordan, flagged file on Walter, flagged file on Tyler. And you can see we don't see anything, right? I don't see anything. So let's dig in a little bit. And this is a more advanced dojo. So they're not going to tell you exactly what to type at this point in the game, because I'm jumping around. At this point in the game, you've already learned a bunch of commands and you've already gotten quite comfortable with them. So now the game challenges you by expecting you to know what commands to do. So like first, let's take a look at what we see. I see a file called You Don't See Me. This is, I mean, I don't know what this is, but let's figure it out, right? So let's echo this to see me dot text, right? Oh wait, I messed up. Echo this into see me dot text. Okay. Oh, what did I mess up here? All right, so now we've got see me dot text, right? And you can see it's the file that we just had. And now let's just do John on it. I don't even know what if this is going to be doing anything. No password sound. Okay, hold on one second. CD apps ls CD backpack ls CD docs. All right, so we've got a we have two like username lists, which is fine. Let's back up here and then let's do CD downloads, and there's nothing in there. Let's do ifconfig to see what our own IP address is. We're localhost at 255. So, a little confused here, y'all. All right, so let's do this. I'm Jerry. Okay, we got that. What is this right here? I mean, this looks like a hash, right? Can we do nmap? See, normally I would do nmap on like the network range, but I don't see a network range. So I guess I didn't have to echo that to a file because I could have just fed the file. I don't have any word list either. This is so weird. I might have to actually like get out of this range really quickly, and go to a different one because I'm confused. And I'm sure it's me. I feel like I've run into this problem before. Oh, there's a wordless directory. I missed that wordless directory. Here we go. Okay. Jerry made a mistake. Your host did not see what was going on. Sorry about that, folks. Okay, so let's say John dash dash word list equals, and then let's do what was it? Documents, word lists, and then rock you text, and then we'll pass the see me text. All right, so there we go. We found a password. All right, all right, good job, everybody. So we just used John the Ripper. We cracked a hash, which has actually told us a username and password and an IP address. So now let's use nmap like a boss and go nmap 10.0.0.0/, let's say 8. Like we're going wide here, people. Oh, it only found the one. Okay, hold on. Let's say 24. It only found the one. All right, so let's do this. We'll just ping that one. There we go. See how it appeared? So now we got Gerald's PC, Carol's PC, and Russell's PC. No three of those are any of the ones that we're actually looking for. But, oh, this is kind of funny. It's Gerald's PC, all right, because I'm also Gerald. All right. So let's SSH Gerald underscore Morris at 10.0.0.201, right? And when it asks us for the password, let's go ahead and copy and paste that in. See what happens. There we go. So we logged in successfully. Very nice. Okay. So first of all, what I'm going to do is this really quickly. And I'm going to go to my little notebook and I'm going to say, I always like to name the note after someone in chat. Jazzy Jazz was there before. First findings. Okay. And let's call this one. This does not simulate Active Directory at this time. Oh, all right. Let's call it CJ. Yeah, CJ's notes. CJ was very nice and is the current Simply Cyber Community Challenge member right now. You guys, I know you can't see because my big head is over the way, but trust me, it's right there. CJ's notes. Thanks, CJ, for playing along. All right, so we got that. So now let's close these notes out and we are inside this box right here, this Gerald box. So now, if we do who am I, we just logged into it as Gerald Morris, right? So let's look around and see what we have. Got all the usual suspects in here. I don't really see much. So I do an ifconfig to see, will the earlier round show you how to use John the Ripper and Nmap? Yeah, absolutely, William Lancaster. I am playing World of Haiku. I have beat the whole thing already, so I can go anywhere in the maps I want. It builds you up, teaching you Nmap first, John the Ripper next, and then Hydra. And like this right here is like a later dojo. I guess I was just wanting to do something a little bit more difficult today. I just kind of wanted the challenge. So it will take you through everything. That's the best part about World of Haiku. It like literally gets you crawl, walk, run from having no experience, no background into doing it. All right. Oh, cool. Wayne Kirkpatrick would love to hear if your son tried this game, what his experience was like. Okay, so you could see I did an ifconfig. The broadcast IP is /24. So the last octet is good to go. So let's go ahead and see if we can scan the Can we scan the entire discover? Oh, there we go. See? We just did an Nmap scan. We did recon, and this thing straight up exploded all up in our face. All right, so we're looking for Jordan's PC, Walter's PC, and Tyler's PC, okay? There's Tyler's PC. So Tyler, I'm gonna take a note here. Tyler is 10.00.246. Let me do this. So Tyler is 10.00.246. Kind of top, back, left-ish. All right. We're also looking for Jordan and Walter. There's Walter. Walter is also top, right, back-ish. And Walter is 10.00.232. Okay. This will come in handy later. And guys, like ethical hackers, bug bounty people, they take notes, guys, because there's usually a ton of information that they got to keep organized. We're looking for Jordan's. Come on, where's Jordan? Jordan, 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 Jordan. Slowly enumerating. There's Jordan. Jordan's 10.00.186. Okay. Jordan is 10.00.186. And that's like bottom left-ish. Okay. Daniel Jordan. Okay, square. Okay, cool. So now we know that we're looking for flag files on these devices. So let's see if we can scan Jordan's box, right? Let's do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to go nmap dash sb dash o, right? We're going for all the things. 10.00.186. What the heck is that? Oh, why is it? Hold on. All right, hold on. Nmap dash sv dash o 10.00.186. Okay. Okay, so we did a quick Nmap scan, and you can see we got all this information back, right? No, Captain G Zero, you definitely don't need to learn how to program first. Hey, Jenny. Jenny Housley has entered the chat. Hey, Jenny. Yeah, you don't need to learn to code. This game is literally designed for zero prerequisites. Okay, so we've got a whole bunch of different things. We're going to try to... Here, you know what I'm actually going to do? I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. I don't normally do this, but this actually does make a lot of sense today. Jordan's PC Nmap output. All right. And let's make it copy-pastable. All right, and then what's another, like, man? So Nmap has a ton of different flags, but they're not all captured in this simulated Linux environment, okay? All right. All right, what are we doing here? Brian Forrest, this game's called World of Haiku. Jenny Housley, yeah, she is. Jenny Housley's the best. All right, so let us do this. We're gonna have to use Hydra to brute force attack, and I would assume the SSH, okay? So let's back up. Let's go back to our machine, okay? And let's do man Hydra, right? Because Hydra's got a lot of flags we need to do. And we're gonna do Hydra SSH :: 10.0.0.186, which is Jordan's PC. And we're gonna say dash L documents, user name, long, okay, and then dash P, and we're gonna say documents, word lists, rock you, okay, and we're gonna let it run. No username match and pass. Okay, so that didn't work, okay. All right, we're gonna try this. That did not work. Current username word list is not appropriate for this username. All right, so we've exhausted both of those. So I don't think we have enough information right now. I don't think we have enough information right now, so let's keep on going. I'm gonna rename this one Jordan. Jordan's PC details. Okay. So now let's go back to let's do nmap dash sv dash o on Walter's machine dash 20. Dude, what is going on? Why can't I type? Like, I'm typing and... Bro. 10.0.0.186. I mean, that's... Jesus, that's Jordan's again. All right, so Walter... Okay, so now we've got a username here. Okay, so let's copy Walter Allen's info off. Okay. Create a new note called... Okay. We'll call this Walter PC details. Okay. And just while we're here, since we're doing it. All right. Looks like we got a password here also, potentially. All right, so let's do this. We'll create a Tyler's PC. Gotta remember, guys, there's no shortcuts. There's no easy button, okay? Like, there's no easy button. You don't just be like, oh, today I'm gonna be a cybersecurity expert, right? Walter Allen 148, excuse me. All right, so Walter, username. All right, so here's the deal. We can use Hydra now because we actually have a username for a machine, so we don't have to brute force both the username and the password. That's why you guys should really be careful. Like when you're, like, it, you know, if someone knows your username, that's like part of the key, right? You're always protecting your password. Here's a little, like, you know, the more you know. Like, let me get my little snake eyes out really quickly. Where's my snake eyes? There you go. Snake eyes, the more you know, G.I. Joe. Listen. It's, I mean, like, you don't protect the username as much as you protect a password, but if someone doesn't have your username and they have your password, they still can't log in as you. You know what I'm saying? So having the username already makes us a little bit further along on being able to crack into Walter's machine here. So let's do Hydra. What was his machine running? Yeah, SSH. Okay, so let's do Hydra SSH 10.0.0.232 and then dash lowercase l, and we're gonna say Walter Allen 148, okay? And then big P, documents. Oh my God, it's not auto-filling, which... Oh my God. All right, big P slash documents. Wait a minute, LS, where am I? Yeah. Hydra SSH dash L dash P documents slash word lists. Rock you. Boom, baby. All right, so we just nailed the username and password for this for this guy. Straight pwnage. We own you, Walter. Okay. All right, so let's log into Walter's box and see what we get. So we're going to SSH Walter underscore Allen underscore 148 at the IP address, his machine, which is 10.0.0.232. And it's going to ask us for the password. And the password is this hot mess right here. I'll give Walter credit. That's a good password. It was in a dictionary. It was in a data dictionary. All right. So we are logged into the machine now. Let's see, here we are up in Walter's machine. Who am I? I'm the captain now. I am Walter now. All right, so let's see what Walter has. That was one of our flags. So let's say flagged file. There we go. All right, so you can see here up the top, we've got a little check mark now. We've completed that flag. Let's keep grinding. Now, I'm just going to back out because it looks like we had Tyler's password, right? Right here. So let's do this. We believe this is the password. So let's go ahead and do Hydra. What did he have running there? He has a couple services. I'm going to try Hydra on SSH first, though, okay? Hydra SSH 10.0.0.246. And we're going to do dash P because we don't know hyphen L. Because we don't know his name, username, but we're going to use a username list to try to figure it out. And then we're going to do dash P, lowercase, and we know his password is this hot mess thing. So let's go. All right, so that didn't work. So maybe it's our username list. So let's do a different one. And there we go. We got his username and password. We're straight smoking this guy, y'all. Good job, everybody. All right, so now we got Tyler's machine. So let's boogie on over there and make him feel uncomfortable, make him feel violated. 10.0.0.246. And his password is this hot mess. Ding, ding, ding. Here we are. We're up in Tyler's machine. Yay. Okay. So let's look on his machine. There's the flagged file. Boing, boing, boing. Good job, everybody. We did it. All right. So let's keep looking at... We got to get Jordan's PC still. Let's look at our Jordan's PC notes and see what we have. Okay. We got Jordan's machine. But it looks like... We tried to Hydra onto Jordan's machine, and we were unable to do it, right? Now, there is a web server running. I have no idea if this is going to work, but we can curl, assuming there's something on the web server's hosting. Access denied. Bum-bum. Access denied. All right. So SMTP is running. I wonder if we can like query more information out of this machine. Yeah, Nmap, we did Nmap. This is the output of the Nmap on that machine earlier. See if I can get more information out of the machine. So SV gives us the software version, dash PN, dash O, specifies ports, okay. So how are we here? Let's take a look on Tyler's machine. Maybe he's got something of value. Cat GT hypothesis. Nope. Oh my God. Okay. Nothing there. I'm just wondering if like, So, I mean, it looks like everything's fake, but All right, I don't know, people. Hey, Sean Washington. So we explored all that. Maybe the trash? Nothing in there. All right, so there's nothing up in Tyler's machine. Let's try potentially a different password list for the Hydra, Jordan's PC Hydra. So let's do Hydra SSH :: 10.0.0.186, right? And we're gonna do -L, and then go to the, by the way, I hope you realize how many times I'm typing all this. This is like why the dojos give you muscle memory and value, because you're like literally typing it over and over again. All right, -P. Now let's try different word lists. All right, and you can see we've got all of them here. Let's go ahead and start with the first one. We'll just iterate over them. Password medium.txt. No username and password. Password short. Nope. Password text medium. Nope. All right, we will iterate over all these. This is the grind, y'all. All right, rock you. Oh, they have username lists here too. Cool. All right, so that's not there. All right, so we've done those iterations. Let's do it. Let's go ahead and try the other username list. I think it's text long. Yeah. And we're gonna use the rock you text. Nope. Okay. I will iterate over all these. Believe that. Nope. Nope. It's not always easy. It's not always straightforward, y'all. Nope. All right. So let's do it again. Rock you. And now let's switch over to the username lists that they have on in the word list directory, okay? So we'll just use username medium, okay? We'll iterate over all these. Nope. Password medium? Nope. Password short? Nope. Password text medium? No. There is not Nikto on here right now. All right, so let us do this. And we're gonna change this to the final word list we have. Oh, hold on. So this is the last username word list we have. Nope. Nope. I'm not feeling very good about this, y'all. Nope. All right. We iterated over every iteration of the username lists and password lists for this machine. So we got to go back and start looking at this box a little bit tighter and see if we can't uncover more about it. So this is the machine, okay, and let's change the flags, right? -SV, okay, it's running that operating system, -O, let me see, -SV, all right. Any thoughts, team? Yeah, so Jenny, is this work for you? This is Nmap with SV and O as the arguments. I'm not getting any, like, you know, I'm not getting anything from it. So it's a little infuriating, honestly. Yeah, exactly. Oh, perfectly, Michael Huskin. How you been, Michael Huskin, by the way? It's good to see you. I'm currently on my own machine. Let's log back into Walter's machine. I don't think we actually, like, looked around Walter's machine for files. We just kind of, like, did what we did and left. So, maybe there is something on his machine we can find. All right, here we go. He's got stuff in here, right? So that's just like filler stuff. Staff meeting, maybe something. Ugh. I was hopeful. Has anybody seen the new Into the Spider-Verse or Across the Spider-Verse? I heard really good things about it. I desperately want to see it. All right, so this is all like whatever fake, not fake, but like fake information. CD downloads, LS, cat, new hires. No. Oh, let's go. Nick says it's amazing. All right. So I've got a really big weekend. A really big weekend coming up. So I don't know when we're going to be able to see it, but I love going to the movies. I love the movie going experience. All right. I don't know where it is, y'all. JoJo saw it too. Awesome. Yeah, I definitely like Into the Spider-Verse. I'm willing to spend like movie theater going prices for that movie going experience. Like just a whatever movie. I'm a little less into that, but Tree. Yeah, Tree's not on here, Bjorn. We loved the first one, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Like, we've watched that. Like, that was like the movie of the summer. I don't know if you guys feel this way, but I feel like every summer, especially when you have kids, there's like one movie or show that like dominates that summer, or one song, like that Sunflower song. Like, we must have listened to that thing like a million times. We don't have Regal near us. We're AMC. We're an AMC joint. Oh, dude, Justin Gold. I love the John Wick series. I haven't seen John Wick 4, but Keanu Reeves crushed that role. All right, can I get a hint? I don't think I'm going to be able to beat this, y'all. I don't think I'm going to be able to beat this, but it doesn't matter. The point was for you guys to be able to see how this thing works and, you know, do what you can. So I'll leave it up for just one more moment. If anyone's got a final thought on how we can possibly discover Jordan's deets. I don't want to iterate over like all the other services. Like, SSH is definitely what you need to pop into. Yeah, no spoilers. All right, guys, so basically, you get the idea. This is World of Haiku. It allows you to train. It's fun. It's easy. It's social. I'm going to leave this. Go back to the map, I think, if I can. Can I go back to the map? Yeah. All right. Oh, Bjorn, that was a really good idea. That is a good idea, Bjorn. right, I'll go back in. All right, I'll go back in. Bjorn has a very good idea. Just like Bjorn told me to like just use a web browser to instead of like some overcomplicated solution for catching a flag in Haiku Pro. Let's go ahead and do Bjorn's suggestion. Let's use the credentials we have already discovered to see if we can SSH onto Jordan's machine. SSH 10.0.0.186. And we're going to do Walter Allen 148@. And we get asked for the password. Permission denied, unfortunately. Okay. So let's try Tyler's creds. It's totally reasonable that they would have credentials or a login there. All right, password. Here we go. Permission denied, okay. And then finally, we had Gerald Morris's password, username and password. We can give it a shot. And did we search Gerald? All right, so that didn't work. Let's actually SSH Gerald Morris at 10.0.0.201. Login. So we're in there. I don't think we like iterated over Gerald Morris's box. Oh, maybe we did. Yeah, never mind. There was nothing here. All right. So we tried it. We tried it, y'all, and we're unsuccessful. But the point was really more about seeing how World of Haiku works and doing the dojo. We got 2 of the 3 flags in the time allotted, which is wonderful. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Spend a minute. Sad Bjorn. Yeah. We'll spend a minute hanging out and talking. But... Miles is in the movie. Good. Yeah, Michael Huskin, World of Haiku, you can get for $25. It's incredibly affordable for what it is. Personal data, that's not a file you can do anything with. That's why I skipped it. I don't think port 25 was listening, Doc. Oh, I don't know who just did that, but I'm literally on stream here. Hold on 1 second. Somebody in my house, we pay for family Spotify, but all the personal digital assistants are configured with my accounts and my Spotify. So if my son wants to hear a song, it takes it over. Yeah, exactly, Justin. You knew it was up. Okay, so I don't know. I had a lot of fun. I was kind of coming in here a little like low energy and trying to play less than Jake to light it up, but definitely had a great experience. Thanks so much for being here today. About 40 of you chilling in chat, hanging out, wrapping up your Monday afternoon with me. Definitely appreciate it. Jojo's asking about Azure AZ 104 over CISP. No, I would definitely, if between those two, I would get CISP 10 out of 10 times. You're welcome, CJ. Thanks again for the super chats this morning. Have a good one, Michael Huskin. Brian Forrest, I was on the Hydra Dojo. I think that's World 6 or Mission 6 Dojo. It was nice to actually catch this for once. Oh yeah, no problem. Yeah, maybe next time, Doc. All right, I love it, Bjorn. Be good. Thanks again for the squad membership. Take it easy. Oh, Ben, I'm okay, buddy. I think I'm going to Costco. I don't take breaks. I work 7 days a week, always doing something. Oh, that's what jawjacking is. Jawjacking's me chilling. All right. Be good, everybody. Thanks so much for catching out the stream. Check out World of Haiku if you're interested. Definitely check out the channel, Simply Cyber, doing live threat briefings every single morning at 8 a.m. Eastern time. If you want to connect with a huge, awesome community and you know, network with like-minded people, plus get up to date on the top cyber threats of the day, come on by simplycyber.io/streams. I'm Jerry, your chat. Be good, everybody. We'll see you next time. Thank you. Yeah, Alexandra, I do the news briefing every weekday morning.